We asked the impossible of our next guest. We wanted her to narrow down her favorite books from the entire year. Carole Barrowman was up to the task, though. She is an English professor at Alverno College. She's a contributor to the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, and she is Santa's book elf, and she is in her Christmas PJs to talk about books. What's up, Carole?
I am great. I'm well, and I'm happy to be here. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays to you too. And you've got some great books there on display because your tradition is that you always buy your two children a new Christmas book, a new book each year, right?
Yeah, I decided when they were very little, we'd buy a Christmas picture book every year. And so now some of them are getting a little worn around the edges. We now have 33 in my collection. And it's so much fun when my grandkids, I take them to them at Christmas, and we read them, actually Christmas Eve, we read them, and it is so much fun. We just go through them all. And so my first book that I had to narrow down this year for you all, for our viewers, is my picture book, my Christmas picture book that I bought for this year.
Okay, so tell us which one it was. I bet it's hard to choose.
It was very hard to choose, but you know how much fun it is just to go through picture books at this time of year? It's great. It's Narwhal's True Christmas Wish. And as I am keeping up here with the younger readers, basically a narwhal is a unicorn, a watery sea creature unicorn. And narwhals, I guess, who knew, are super popular right now in children's picture books. So this is a story about a narwhal who wants to be Santa's helper. And Santa, of course, he finds out about this true wish when he loses a package under the water, and the narwhal rescues this present and helps save somebody's Christmas.
Aw, that's adorable. I love that choice. That's fantastic. I bet it was tough in the mystery category, Carole, because this is a category you love, one that you write about often.
Yes, it was very, very difficult. So many mysteries, but I'm picking this one, The King's Justice, because it's both a historical mystery and just a really, really good story. And it's about a young woman who was once a spy for Winston Churchill. And it takes place in 1943, so during the end of the Second World War. And an unexploded bomb is found in the River Thames. And the story goes from there. And Maggie Hope, the main character, helps figure out what's going on and why that bomb is there. And it's taut and suspenseful and super engaging. You'll just get lost in it. It was one of my favorite mysteries of the year.
Oh, fantastic. My book club's always looking for a new read. And so you had to pick just one book club read for 2020.
So this one is Hamnet, not Hamlet, but Hamnet. And it is the story of Shakespeare and about his loss of a son. And that was his son's name. So this is fictional, but it's set in the world of Shakespeare. And it is beautiful. I have to say, and I read a lot, as you know, this is probably one of the most beautifully written books I've read, not just this year, but in the last couple of years. It's breathtaking in its use of language and its setting. And even if you don't know a lot about Shakespeare, everybody's heard of Hamlet. And it turns out that Hamnet, his son, had some inspiration, gave them, and his death gave Shakespeare and his wife some inspiration for the play Hamlet. It is it's just a beautiful book about family and loss and how art can heal us.
Interesting. I know they had a turbulent marriage, which is also kind of covered in the book as well, right?
Yes. Very turbulent marriage and very passionate.
Okay. There you got to have a little passion to have a good book club read, I guess.
Right.
Right. For sure. Okay, this I think in this year, with so much going on in our world, you picked one book that's about taking action.
Yeah, so many of us have been reading a lot of books that have been recommended by Black authors to help us become better allies in bringing about change in our society, but also being better ancestors. And so, but I wanted to be able to do something and really have something applied in my life. So this book is called Me and White Supremacy, and it's by Layla Saad. And this book is really a book that takes you through a 28-day journaling process where you have to be honest with yourself, you have to be authentic, and you go through this journaling process to sort of explore and open up all the ways in which you're as a privileged white person, my hidden biases, and it's a powerful, very powerful book. And I also think it would be a really good book club if you've got some three or four people in your book club who are willing to really do this hard work with you. I highly recommend it. A very empowering process to go through.
It's funny because as you were talking about that book, I thought about it from my book club. I think it sounds very powerful and something I think it's okay to force ourselves to think about tough things. So I like that one. And lastly, Carole, I think especially with 2020, we need a book that's funny. We need to laugh.
This book is hilarious. And it is the book is written by a woman who is mostly known in the internet. Samantha Irby, and I know Tiff knows about her. Wow, no thank you. And she takes on middle age, she takes on all sorts of little details, menopause, which is not a little detail, but she takes on all sorts of things about what it means to live in the world today, particularly as a middle-aged woman trying to make a living as a writer and so on. It is really kind of laugh out loud funny. I annoyed my husband to no end just reading bits to him while I was going through it. And yes, we all need to laugh more than ever right now. And I highly recommend this one.
Great recommendations, Carole. You were definitely up to the task. I'm so glad that we went through your list. Thank you so much and happy holidays to you.
Happy holidays to all of you. Thank you.
Absolutely. You look great in your PJs there. So we got
to
make sure.
Head on back to bed.
Yeah, there you go. Head on back to bed. All right.
We will
post all of Carole's recommendations on our website, themorningblend.com. But if you want to connect with Carole or read her blogs, you can visit her website, which is carolebarrowman.com.